What you got going on up in the kitchen, Roach? You got some collard greens, some black eyed peas, fried chicken, pasta.
What's up, guys? And welcome to my channel, What You Cookin' Rolls. Alright? And for those that are new to my channel, welcome. I appreciate the love. Make sure you subscribe and hit that reminder button so you know when I upload a new video. Alright? So, you already know by the thumbnail, I'm getting ready to make some short rib lasagna rolls with this fine pieces of short ribs. Now, this is a recipe that I found online by this lady Gilda at Home. It's a food network. But I wanted to do something different with some short ribs I bought. And also, I was thinking, you know, some different ideas to do with lasagna. So I came across this recipe, and I got a few extra steps in it, you know, but we all gonna try it, all right? We're gonna see what this is all about, okay? So, you already know. Let's get started. Okay, y'all see what we got here? I know it looks like a lot, okay? But it's really not. It's just that these are the ingredients that's needed to take to have to make this particular meal. All right, so y'all already see the beef short ribs, and so I'm kind of reading off the ingredients because I don't want to jack them up, but I see what we got here. Basically, we're gonna need our garlic. You're gonna need garlic. I'll put all the ingredients in the description below, okay? We're gonna need one large onion. You're gonna need some olive oil. You're gonna need some heavy whipping cream, because when we make that cream cheese sauce that she has, that we're making to, for the filling of the lasagna roll, all right? So we got a kosher salt. I took a liberty in making my own beef broth. I would suggest that. Just get you a piece of beef cut, bone, and doing your own. It's always the best. And also, we're going to have our wine, red wine of any of your choice that you want. I just prefer this brand here. But you're going to need two cups of that. So you got your cheese, your own Parmesan cheese, and some mozzarella, all right? And this particular recipe has spinach also in it, so you want to drain that. The ingredients in the description saying that you want to drain this and get all the water off this as possible. Get as much as off as you can, which we're working on it. You can see it draining off there, all right? So, all right, now, we're gonna get started, because you already know it's not gonna cook itself. All right, so let's get this beef short rib lasagna rolls popping. Let's go. Okay, y'all, so now we're gonna season the meat, all right? It's just simple, you know, you ain't gotta get all crazy. Just put some salt and pepper, you know. It's okay to use that Lowry's, because I've been using that Lowry's too, you know, but this recipe, we're just gonna keep it simple. And then we see what it tastes like. Alright. I have no doubt in my mind it's in flavors. And you know, also, like I said, it takes two cups and a half of your favorite red wine. And that's gonna take that flavor to the flavor town. I mean, whoo! I'm excited. Alright, so you see what I'm doing here. Now I'm just seasoning this. Because we're gonna put this in a heavy Dutch pot. I love my Dutch pot. And then we're gonna sear these and brown them up, all right? All right, don't be afraid of that fat over there. It's okay. It's gonna give us some flavor. All right, so you see what I'm doing? Now, I'm gonna rub some gloves on and get this and rub it down. And then we'll be right back, okay? And we'll get this in the pot. Alright, so I've already gone ahead and browned our meat, so we're going to add in some coarsely chopped onions, alright? So you want to use a whole onion, and you got your garlic too. So now you want to save some of your garlic because, believe it or not, some of the garlic is going to go into your cream cheese sauce. Okay, that's done. That's I'm ready. I'm excited about this. All right, so you see what I'm doing here. Just going to cut these onion. You know, you want to give it a nice little cut to get it to a coarse, you know, chunk. So you want to have it about kind of like, you know, like this meat, this size here, whatever size that is. Okay. All right, so we're going to continue with that. And I also have a spree of rosemary. And that's also going to go into the pan as well, too, when we saute our onion, okay, and garlic, okay? So we're going to get a quick rough chop. So we got that nicely chopped there, okay? We got a little bit left. All right, I'm going to get a bowl real quick because my eyes are watering. Just can't see it. My goodness. Okay, let me get a bowl. Hold on. Alright, we just probably need to chop a little bit more, right? Like, get walk away from the onions. Alright. There we go. Alright, got myself together. Alright. Okay, you see what we're doing there, alright? So I'm going to put those in the bowl, okay? And then we're going to start the garlic, okay? Oh, my eyes are watering again! Alright, get these onions out of the way. Alright, so you see that we got our whole medium onion there. Alright, we're gonna lose our rosemary though. Okay, now we're gonna get our. Press my knife off a little bit. Now we're gonna get our garlic together. Alright, so you're gonna tap down on that lightly. Be careful, don't cut yourself. Not everybody can do that. Alright? So, I don't want nobody out there thinking they can just pound on that and they slip up and that knife slide across your hand. And we don't even want to go there, alright? Alright, so we're going to slice that up. Alright, like so. And some of these are easy. You can just pound. You can also pound it with your hand, too. Alright? Just don't pound too hard. You don't want to mush it too hard, right? Okay. All right. So you guys see what I'm doing here, all right? So I'm going to get this all minced up, and then we'll come back. We're going to put this in the Dutch pot, and we're going to saute them up and get ready for the next step, all right? I'll see y'all then. All right, y'all. Y'all know this dinner is not going to get cooked itself, okay? So we're going to get these onions sauteed. Got some nice... burnt little bits in there, that's what you want. And like I said, you want to cook your onion and get them translucent. You want to add in your garlic as well. And add that in like so. And we're going, like I said, get it translucent. So we're going to cook that for like, 5 minutes. So, I'm going to take your spoon so you can scrape that and get all the juicy goodness off of the bottom of that pan. Oh, man. Oh man, it's so aromatic. Oh, if you can smell it, you guys. Oh, that's awesome. All right. Now, after observing my beef short ribs over there, I got quite a lot of meat over there on them suckers. Some of them might, let me shred that because basically what we're doing here is we're getting ready to start the process of getting our meat tender. And so it kind of, you know, like you do, you know, you boil in your meat, but it's in the season, like if you make neck bones or something like that, or, you know, you're boiling your chicken. That's what we're doing here with these beef short ribs, but we're going to be adding in, we're going to be fancy. We're going to be adding in some red wine and some beef stock. And we're going to literally, we're going to have to let this cook for 2 hours, I mean, until tender. And then once we do that, Lord, I'm going to have my eye up and turn it up. Cook and then we're shredding the meat, all right, and then we start that process of making that cream cheese. Yeah, like I said, it's some steps to it, but I think it's going to be worth it. All right, I'm interested to try something new. There's nothing wrong with trying something new, you know, and different. You never know what you might come up with or experience. All right, some getting that nice and sauteed. All right, you guys, so we're going to add in that red wine, okay? So that's 2 cups, but I think I got a little, you know, I know I got more meat, but then with the recipe calls for, so I'm just going to add in. I know, but I put the descriptions below. And I think that's about 2.5 cups there, all right? It might be a little bit more, but that's okay. And stir that up a little bit. Scrape off the little goodness and the juicy bits from the bottom of that. All right. I think it's not quite 2 cups. I mean, you might have to add a little bit more. Now, let me. Yeah. All right. There we go. I think we're done. All right. So we're just gonna stir that. Oh man. Oh, that smells good. I feel like I'm cooking like a fancy chef over here. Get me over here cooking with some wine. All right. Bring that to a boil, so then we're going to need to add in our beef broth, all right? So I'm so excited because I made it myself, all right? So we're going to add in that, and that's going to be 2 cups as well, too. And that's going to be just a little bit more because just the fact that I got my beef ribs, I think I got a little bit more than the 2.5 pounds, all right? So, all right. I'm just going to stir that up. That smells good. Now, don't mind the time in there. What's going to happen is these leaves are going to fall off that, and then you can just take the stems off at the end, okay? So, we're going to add in our beef short ribs, all right? Like so. Now, from what the description says, is that when you put these in there, you want some of the beef short ribs showing up on the top. But, I think, like I said, I got more. And I think I'm just going to kind of have it overflow there a little bit. Plus, I got some extras in here. But with these babies, I'm going to put these in the grill. And we're going to grill those, all right? Because, like I said, I got more than what I thought I was going to have. Plus, I had used these pieces here to make my beef broth, okay? All right, y'all. So, we have the half mark, all right? We're just going to let this cook for 2 hours. And then I'll start my cream cheese sauce that we're gonna be needing to go apart with this as well too, all right? I'm gonna make myself a cocktail and I'll see y'all later, all right? Alright y'all, so our meat is ready. So we're going to put it in this bowl, get it so we can get it nice. We're going to shred it, and we're going to add it to that cheese sauce that's on the side. Alright, because that's how Gilda is doing that, alright? But this gravy up in here, ooh, it's fire. I just hate to get rid of it, to lose that. Cooking in that red wine gravy, we don't want to stick, see? That was not telling you guys how the thyme leaves will fall off, you know, so. Just want to get your meat out, and yeah, of course, I think I got way more than 2.5 pounds. I think I maybe got 3, shit, maybe 4. That gravy is hitting me. I gotta get rid of it. Alright, so now we're gonna add our beef into the cheese sauce. This is what Gilda's doing. I'm telling you, I'm sorry. I've been sampling that with that cooking in that wine sauce. I feel like I'm all elegant.